these hermit crabs are sizing each other's shells up to swap them.
Track.
It's like a fractal crab.
It's the lizard. Oh. Okay, back into your housey. See you later. Oh, it's home. Yeah, boy.
Day two.
Oh, is this around the spines?
Yeah.
Oh.
There we go, he's happy now, he's letting himself down.
Oh, he's chilled.
It's one of the saddest things in the world when you kill one, it goes.
Oh, like a deflated football.
Yeah.
Oh.
Here's the fish.
So this is a snapper?
Yeah, pretty sure this is a rainbow snapper.
Wow. That's a beast.
It's not bad.
Ooh. I reckon you're gonna get two at once.
Yeah, better look.
This way. He's just gone off the right side.
Good morning, day three, and I am off to my own little beachy island to start making my shelter. So here we go. If you're wondering why there's a massive concrete path leading halfway there, it's because they started building a house overlooking the big main beach about 100 years ago. But they never finished it. As like ropey stuff and plait it and make it a bit stronger, but when all this is washed up there's no reason to go to that trouble really when it's available to use. And there's loads, and this is just what was around here, but if we go down the beach there's bound to be loads more rope and all sorts. So this big thick rope you can punch apart and make little ropes, and then I'm going to use a really good knot called a granny knot, and this is what grannies have used for hundreds of years to build shelters. Okay, so you just knot it however the hell you want to, and that's a granny knot. Wow.
My eyes are closed,
this is
laid down. I'm getting on the iPad on the way home.
Wilson, we have fire!
Yeah, we have fire.
Oh shit. Oh.
Fire by friction.
Well done.
Awesome.
Well done.
That was amazing actually seeing it. That was really awesome.
That is
really
cool.
Cool. Wow.
Your turn. It's a lot.
do you?
Oh, he's coming out.
He doesn't want to come out, does he?
No, he'll be foolish. Beautiful colour.
Wow. Wow, that's beautiful. It really is awesome, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a really lovely trail.
Ooh.
Hey, that'll make for good footage.
It would.
Whoa!
I caught a fish using a bottle.
You get one, mate.
Oh, we must remember to take our kindling and put it under something.
See those things?
Defo, it's unusual, sure, isn't it?
Here's your hermit crab.
They look hideous. Ooh.
A hermit crab without a shell.
Naked hermit. Oh. I want a home.
I know. I'm in real trouble here.
Uh oh, you're going to get eaten.
He's got a good
unless
chance
he finds someone.
Oi!
Get off me! It's not the right time. Oh no!
Well, these are really hard to cut off.
It's what?
A nudie brank.
A nudie brank?
Yeah. Latin for naked bum. See those things on the back? That's what it breathes through.
Ooh.
You get them like the coolest colours if you Google nudie brank. You get them like proper UV rays, like purples and oranges and yellows. The ones I've seen here are really dull in comparison. Well, they're very cool to see.
That's awesome.
Can you eat all the way to the fins, can you, Tom? Yeah, as far as I'm aware, this is all just muscle. I mean, what meat is muscle, isn't it?
Oh, it is hard to cut, isn't it?
tastes like
Buon appetito.
£100 bottle now.
Om nom nom.
Now I'm on my own for 3 days. I had the option of bringing a hammock, which I have done, so it's a bit of security. So I'm just going to put that up between these two trees, cleared a little area. There was a group of four, me and three others. One of them has gone home and the other two have opted to have hammocks. And they're at the other end of the beach in the far, far distance, that way somewhere. And I've kind of chickened out and got a hammock as well, because it's a good security and the midges are relentless, and the mesh hat I have, the holes are too big and they let the midges through. So the thought of spending the night in a not already built shelter getting bitten by midges isn't too enticing. So I'm going to put this up at least to give me some peace of mind to know that I can jump in there if I don't feel like spending the night in this area. And I've got a tarp. Oh Mike, you big cheat, you've got a tarp. That's not survival. I know it's cheating, but I think if you have the option of having a tarp, you would do as well, because it's the rainy season and it's very rainy and it's not nice being wet. It was fun putting up the hammock. I found a family of little lizards who were just chilling in this little gap. And they had a little baby, which is cool. I made sure not to disturb them because it's their little house. So I've got 3 days here, I think, for today at least, because the rain, not the rain, but the wind's picking up. I think we're going to have a big thunderstorm. It's going to be really, really sad if I don't have a funky fire to cook coconut on or some crap. So I'm thinking just making a fire in this area here. And for those who know me, I like fire, so it should be fun. And I've got a furrow stick and a knife to rub against it. Hopefully make fire, which still isn't all that easy, especially when it's rainy season and lots of stuff is damp. But I'll do a time lapse of me doing it, as opposed to a video, so don't hear me swearing loads. Brilliant. Okie dokie. So I'm off to get wood. I think you're told to kill him, but I don't really want to kill it, so I might take the log, try not to get stung, and pop it at the end of the beach, so he's free to do his little shizzle. Holy shit! Oh, bloody hell. Okay. Okay. I've made my scorpion transporter. So here he is, getting a humanoid view. Look at him go. Look at a scorpion mobile. Go and shove him somewhere out of the way. Here's a baby, one of those massive spiders that's decided to make a little nest. Check it out. You see that? Oh my god. Yay. Oh, this one's so quick on me. Awesome. I'm just going to eat that now, it's almost time. Yay! Food! Nom 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 nom. It's really tasty. A few things I want to do now is chop it into little strips and put it on the fire. It tastes really nice. It tastes popcorn-y, which is cool. Never thought about putting it on the fire. Mr. Tom was like, put it on the fire, it tastes like popcorn. We did, and lo and behold, it tastes like popcorn. Fact that I tidied the camp, it took me like an hour, but it's just really nice. Nice looking area. If I can sort of brew out, that'd be awesome, wouldn't it? Let's try and sort that out. Can't really see the sunset tonight because it's so cloudy. It's very, very windy and it seems to be picking up. So I think we're due a storm. Oh, bugger. So I've got loads of firewood. I'm going to go batten down the hatches. This is my little tea contraption I made to try and make a brew. At the moment it's cold, so we'll see how that does in a bit. Hopefully I'll have a brew sometime this evening. That's some salt. This is my view from this side. It was a success. Look, it's brewing in my bottle. Oh. So we're gonna have peppermint tea for bed. Yeah. I've also got some dead termite nest on the fire. Keep the mosquitoes and bitey bits away. This is the stuff. You can use the live stuff as well, but I feel a bit mean, so I'll just keep finding dead bits and popping them on. Super duper!
Massive storm in the night. Very, 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 very wet. I'm glad I have my tarp. So obviously my fire's out. I'm very hungry. I'm a bit sweaty and clammy. But yeah, stayed relatively dry, which is good. The rain stopped now and the wind's died down, so all the midges are out, so I'm just kind of sat waiting to battle the midges, so you can see them through the netting of the hammock.
So you get a new tide twice a day and it can waft up loads of funky stuff, so a great thing to do is to go beachcombing every day. Just look at all this stuff. Let's do some beachcombing. Okay. serious note though, you can find lots of stuff. And it's surprising how many bottles of actual fresh water you find. There's one here. There's a bottle of what looks like Coca-Cola.
A bottle with some water in.
So yeah, in like a super survival situation, you could find enough water easily on a beach around here to live off for a couple of days while you set up loads of like bottle traps and stuff, I guess. Seems to be some kind of crazy ant party going on next to my hammock, which is a bit annoying.
Check out these guys.
Ow, I'm gonna fucking bite as well. Ow, go away. This is the noni plant. It tastes of blue cheese and is not very nice in the slightest, but it's supposed to be really good for you. So in a real survival situation, you just stomach it and eat loads of these. It's like a weird, warty alien frog. Try and get some green coconuts from this tree. There's loads and it tastes nice. When they're green, they have the coconut watery stuff inside.
That is good.
And refreshing. So there's a big funky stick. So I'm going to try and use that. So I'll let you know if I get any. Fingers crossed. I managed to get two juicy coconuts. And sand in my eye. There it is. Jerk it out. This is going to be very tasty. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, it's so sweet. You get loads. It's really heavy. Cool. I'm going to enjoy this and recharge. Just getting my fire going on day two because it went out last night in the rain. And it's doing alright. It's like a little teepee. So just wait for that to take and then I'll get some logs on and Bob's your uncle. sure why, but now there's like a dozen of these butterflies all around my little campy bit. And I don't think it's the fire, because I didn't see them yesterday. It's really cool. I want to see if you can catch any on camera. I'm witnessing some crazy butterfly mating ritual-y thing. Ooh, I'm just really by my face. Cool. Think about is this meal that we're going to go to tomorrow night after we get picked up. I know we're getting picked up tomorrow morning, and then tomorrow night after we've had like a 6-hour shower, we're going to get taken to some fancy pizza restaurant on the island, which would be amazing. So yeah, sounds pretty good. And it'd be nice to get all this brown, mucky, salty, crappiness. And have you seen the state of my clothes? Time to have a wash, I reckon, after 8 days. And I've probably never gone this long without a shave, actually. I'm not really sure what I look like, but there you go. Okie dokie. Me again. Still feeling really drained, but something Tom said earlier has stuck with me. He said, don't count the hours, make the hours count, or something along those lines. So instead of sitting here, sitting in my hammock going, oh, I'm exhausted, can't wait to get picked up at 9, I'm just going to drearily make the effort to get some beautiful footage and shots and just really make the most of it, because it is stunning, but I just feel absolutely shattered. But I'm going to try and do some time lapses of the clouds and some more aerial stuff, so we'll see how we get on. Thank you. This place is absolutely stunning. I've just been for a fly around, and it's really cheered me up. It's absolutely beautiful. I can't wait to like look at the footage when I get back. It's really amazing. You kind of lose a bit of sight of that, a little bit, yeah, what am I trying to say? You kind of lose sight of that when you're hungry and bitten and dirty and just all a bit bleh. But it is a stunning place to be, and I'm really lucky to actually be here. So yeah, I just wanted to share that. I think I'm ready to go now. It's been a heck of a experience, and I'm really happy I've done it. I'm pretty much enjoyed the whole time, genuinely. It makes you really appreciate the little things. I think the biggest thing for me is it's made me realise to not sweat the small stuff, and it doesn't matter if you're a bit dirty, and it doesn't matter if you feel a bit grimy or whatnot, and you're a bit down, just get on with it. There's a cool little boat there, look. Oh, these are the coconut hunters that came on the island apparently the other day. And we were a bit narked because we were on it, because they wanted the coconuts. Unless that's the boat that I was supposed to go on and my watch is wrong, that'll be a ball ache. I'm sure it's not. So yeah, don't sweat the small stuff and appreciate everything that you have back home. And appreciate the beauty of nature as well. Like, holy crap, this place is absolutely magnificent. But considering like no people are here, no tourists are here, there's no one here to ruin it. We still ruin it from afar by making all this rubbish. It's ridiculous. So I think that's been a huge wake-up call. I think the only time on the island I've got a little bit emotional was just when, I think it was on the second day, when I was just scraping through all the crap and all the rubbish that had washed up. And it is just a huge, big wake-up call. It's ridiculous. Really ridiculous. But then again, if you were marooned here in a survival situation, then all the plastic bottles that washed up would probably help you survive dramatically. But that's still no excuse for making those mess in the world. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it. I'm going to wander back to the beach. Filming this hermit crab in a bottle top. It's waiting for him to come out. Boat is here, finally. Yay! And this is, ow, stomped myself in the head. And this is what's remaining of the main campy bit. All disassembled and fire put out. And now we're going to have a half hour boat ride, and then I'm going to have a shower. Yeah! Can't wait. Bye bye, Mr. Hermit Crab. Hello, boat.
We'll be right back.